Howdy, gang. We are live again from Anchorage, Alaska. This is yours truly, Zelmo the Unruly. We're about to dive right back into this game. I think I got up to level 8 or something, so I'm not really that far into the game. Yeah, I'm a level 8 necromancer. I'm just gonna play offline tonight. You knew where I left off last time. I streamed this before, but I didn't like how it turned out, so I ended up just getting rid of it. We're just gonna keep on keeping on. This is one of those kinds of games where you'll start at any level you want, essentially. It's not gonna really matter much to the plot of the game. Essentially, you're just looting and you're fighting animals and enemies, and I'm gonna go back to where I came from. I guess I was in the Stony Field last time. Go back there. Like a necromancer, so you can resurrect dead bodies to assist you on your journey here. Doing here. Okay, I guess turning on the map helps a lot. I am definitely overburdened. I was gonna try to sell this thing. Yeah, let's do that. Let's go back to just keep going. I guess three guys are my maximum. I wanna go to parts of the map that I have not opened yet, so. Yeah, I tried live streaming Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 last night. If you're on my Twitch channel, you might have seen that. Something happened. Twitch had crashed or something. What was, I thought was a pretty good 2-hour-plus session, ended up only being like a minute and a half according to Twitch, so... Sword broke, why? Sword. I need a sword. Somebody give me a sword. That is a movie quote. Actually, I take back that movie quote because I'm not sure if I said it right. It's gonna be from Gladiator 2000 when the Emperor lost his sword, so he's shouting out somebody to give him a sword. And I'm not sure if I said it right, so we're gonna retract that one. What's that? But I do need a sword, because right now I'm gonna turn around this stupid knife. Interesting. A lot of folks complaining about how they couldn't access the online features on this game when it first came out. A lot of negative reviews on it, but I mean, play offline should be fine, right? I'm not that big of a fan of online gaming because people online tend to ruin the experience for you. I mean, granted, yeah, it could be fun, but then you always run into one or two of those assholes that like to take away the immersive experience. Find a little scroll of identifies. This. Blood Raven. A sword. Come on, somebody give me a sword. I got my stash here. Nothing. Let's see here. Scimitar ran out of durability really quick. Strength yet. Some of these. Give you much options, do they? Other armor, bolted armor. Thank you. Alright, folks, I'm just gearing up here. Back to where we came from, shall we? Oh, where's my, didn't say my portal. Well, that sucks. I didn't know that would not save your portal. Ain't that a bummer? Nice, I'll go back here. Already here, wasn't I? Cool. I know, it's a little light bursting, the gimmick that they do, but still, it's fun to see. Easily impressed. Most of this map is open, right? So I've been here before. Alrighty. Getting you on over this way. Ed Rogue, here we go. Yeah, it's a shame that Twitch crashed last night, because on that flight simulator game, I was flying a experimental aircraft from Anchorage, Alaska to Seattle, Washington in the game. And then I went to try to land at Seattle's airport, and then after about 2 hours or so, and then the game crashed on me. And then I'm back to the Xbox, like, dashboard for my Xbox, the Series X. Went to check the Twitch feed to see how much of it I had managed to save, only find out that the Twitch feed had only gone for about a minute and a half, so basically lost over 2 hours of 2 hours of work, essentially. Which is lame, because the whole time I was flying, it's all talking like you're there, you know, nobody's even listening to me. For some reason, I didn't notice that the little streaming thing, the feed light, whatever, the little, like, recording, the little, recording light says that you're streaming. Apparently was not even on that whole time, so yeah, that was slightly disappointing. Being facetious, that was very disappointing. Okay, I was pissed. Okay, I was pissed that it didn't save anything, but but, you know, shit happens, and then you just kind of move on. You got room for a ring, asshole. What the hell is this? Sell it. This guy keeps resurrecting him. Got two. Here, I gotta use up some of this crap I'm carrying. Where's my scimitar right there? Interesting. Okay. There's another tunnel over here. Or maybe not. Okay. Yeah, it's already here. Okay. Okay. guess all the enemies respawn. Down this way. There they are. Skill points. I don't have level 12 yet. Can't carry anymore. Be the dark wood. Let's go to the dark wood. I'm in the dark wood. Out of here then. Alright, let's go and sell some of our shit here. Let's not sell it. What if I want to play a druid later? Where's my stash? Like, yo, bro, where's my stash, man? Right here, man. This is socketed. Ooh, I got an achievement. Socketed gem. Make room here. All right, let's go talk to the dude again. Get some more weapons or something. Armor. We need armor. I only got $1,000, so damn. That's a little better. Two-handed spear. Back to the dark woods. The dark woods whence we came. Like how they all talk weird British in those kind of movies. That's more like it. Got these houses here. I wanted to do another live stream rant earlier tonight, but I don't know. A lot of the stuff I want to talk about has already been covered to death in the news. Kind of not really sure what to rant about at this point. I do know that the I do know that the mob who is currently they're still at the altar of worship regarding the January 6th committee. I know they're in for a rude awakening when word finally gets out in the mainstream news media that January 6th committee is essentially powerless at this point. They will not refer Trump to the Department of Justice for prosecution. One of the senators on the committee flat out said that they're not going to refer Trump. It's not going to happen. There's really nothing to quote unquote get Trump on. There's nothing that's what they call actionable. They can't really do anything. Department of Justice really doesn't seem eager to go after Trump on anything. They just don't have anything really on him. People are gonna say, "Oh, there's tons of evidence out there." Well, there's tons of people talking about things, but nothing substantial, really. To the point where they're so desperate to get him on something that now they're falling back on all these old arguments that have been debunked for the past few years now. They're saying now there's proof that what's that guy's name? Paul Manafort. There's proof that he talked to the Russians or something, the Trump's 2016 campaign, because he admitted it or something. He finally admitted to talking to someone, some Russian agent, whatever, but he said for his own personal gain, had nothing to do with Trump's campaign. Paul Manafort was essentially pulling a Fredo from Godfather Part 2. You remember when Fredo said to Michael Corleone, he said, "But there was something in it for me, Mikey. There was something in it for me," he said. That's essentially what Paul Manafort said. He did a little side hustle without Trump's knowledge during the Trump campaign 2016, where Paul Manafort was trying to get some extra cash out of this There it is. Hold on, we're gonna cheat here. But anyway, Paul Manafort was essentially saying that he was just in it for his own personal gain and not for Trump's. So really, there's very little that they could even consider making a case out of in regards to trying to bring any kind of prosecution against Trump. Much as people would like to believe otherwise, there's a reason why they've been going after Trump for about 6 years now. And so far, they have produced nothing. Nothing beyond, you know, maybe some tax return, you know, garbage. Punch the shit out of this gas hole. There we go. Now I got a bodyguard. Find out where I left all my shit. So, follow the road. I think it's right up here. Dash over here. There it is. All my stuff right here. Able to find all my old shit. Thank goodness. I'm fully rejuvenated. And I'm back to being overburdened, so. My vitality should be raised. I feel healthier already. But, yeah, regards to, everybody who's in support of the Trump witch hunt, all I can say is one of my favorite sayings, to bring people, back down to earth is prepare to be disappointed. Yeah. You're not gonna like what you're gonna see in the next few months if you're a Trump witch hunter. They just cannot touch the guy. And I know it's frustrating because the guy is an asshole, okay? You know it, I know it. We can at least agree on that point. And I know you feel there's no justice in the world. The assholes like him can get away with being an asshole. But, sorry to say, folks, but being an asshole is not against the law. Being an asshole is not an impeachable offense. I never liked about these kind of games is I really wish you could zoom in more on the action like you could in those Titan Quest games. Zoom out, you can zoom in. These graphics look good enough where I want to appreciate them up close, you know what I'm saying? Granted, that same problem with Diablo 3. I'm carrying him. I can't carry him. On to other news. Liz Cheney, remember her? Claims to be a Republican, but really about as a Democrat as they come, and I'll explain that to you here in a bit. But yeah, she's apparently losing in Wyoming so badly now that she's essentially on her way out. She's not even trying anymore. She's losing to some guy I never heard of. But whoever her opponent is over there, because I guess a while back she made the mistake of saying something to the effect of that she's not going to listen to a bunch of crazies in her home state just to get reelected. Was essentially most of her constituents, people who were actually the ones that should have been trying to get the vote. Well, now she's feeling repercussions of that. Anymore. All right, time to kind of make some room here. How big is this stupid scroll supposed to be? Quantity, not sure if I want to get rid of that. Just stash some of these potions. Last time I was in town, drop some of these around everywhere. Yeah, essentially Liz Cheney, the daughter of freaking Dick Cheney, is losing now in Wyoming so badly because of her insult to her own constituents that she's essentially lost the election in Wyoming and is now essentially a lame duck. If she loses the primary, which looks like that's what's going to happen, yeah, she'll still be their representative until November when the actual election comes along, midterm election, but... And she can still, like, work in Congress, but she's essentially pretty much a lame duck until then. She's got, like, I guess she's still on the January 6th committee for what that's worth. I mean, it's really, you might as well call it the no balls community, because they can't do anything. They have no power. as we've been telling these liberal leftist like Democrats for the past year and a half now, that the January 6th committee is essentially just about as powerless as the Warren Commission, you know, which I mean, the Warren Commission is essentially the same as the J6 committee. There's no, it's got, they have no teeth. They really can't do anything. And like the Warren Commission, nothing was actually done about, JFK's assassination. You know, they came to the conclusion that the guy who they pegged the assassination acted alone, and he was already dead, so there's really nothing they could do. And everything got swept under the rug, it's classified, and the J6 committee's thing is pretty much turning out to be the same thing. So, yeah. That's, in a nutshell, what's currently going on. Of course, the news doesn't want to talk about the fact that the J6 committee is basically pointless right now, so they're trying to hide it with this whole Trump FBI raid of nuclear documents. Apparently Trump was in possession of nuclear documents for the past 18 months since he left the White House, and FBI supposedly knew about it the entire time. It raises a question: if he supposedly had nuclear documents, why did they not do anything about it beforehand if these documents are so important? Means I'm calling bullshit on that. I think that nuclear documents thing is just something they pulled out of their ass as a cheap excuse to raid the house in Mar-a-Lago as essentially just a fishing expedition, hoping to find something or anything that they could pin on Trump before he decides to officially run president, which will be any day or any week now. Of course, the news is following suit. You know, they're yapping, they're flapping their gums, yapping away, trying to make sure that the sheep keep watching the pointless news propaganda broadcast. If I sound apathetic, it's because I don't give a shit at this point, you know. There's no real crisis here aside from basically all that's been manufactured up to this point, like the whole Biden inflation thing, that's all manufactured as well. Manufactured in part by the Biden administration for essentially creating an inflationary crisis when there really was not one to begin with. If Go Brandon had just left everything alone upon entering the White House, if he had just left Trump's policies alone, left things the way they were, I'm pretty certain that things would not be the way that would not be as terrible as they are right now. Gas prices would still be relatively reasonable. They might have gone up maybe a little bit if Go Brandon hadn't actually tried to change things. Entering the Black Marsh. Not do that yet. Some unexplored parts of this map I want to get into here. Going back to the FBI Mar-a-Lago thing. And again, I covered this when I did a... Well, I'm calling a podcast. I don't know. You can call whatever you want, but... When I did my little rant the other night regarding what Trump probably was doing long, even like before he left the White House, he was taking full advantage of his essentially unlimited power as the president to classify and to declassify things basically at his own whim and leisure, you know, because he had unlimited power to do so because he is the president of the U.S., president of the United States of America, has the power to classify and to declassify essentially anything. Even so-called nuclear secrets, nuclear documents that he allegedly had in his possession in Mar-a-Lago, if that story is even true, Trump had the power to declassify them essentially just by mentioning them. He said, hey, guess what? He could have said this, hey, guess what? I have got these nuclear codes here. I'm just gonna, these nuclear documents, whatever information is on those alleged documents. Essentially, they were his to classify or declassify. But basically, they were at his disposal. I mean, who's going to tell the president that he can't classify or declassify information? You know, that he's talking to a diplomat or a foreign leader, like say Xi Jinping or Vladimir Putin or Macron or even that Canadian asshole, what's his name, Justin Trudeau. You know, the blackface guy, the guy who dressed up as a black guy at some party years ago. Yeah, Trudeau, the Canadian, for what that's worth. You know, you're going to tell Trump he can't discuss nuclear armament or like disarmament or nuclear power related subjects, nuclear armament related subjects or topics with a foreign leader because it's classified? I mean, think about that. Who's gonna tell the president you can't talk about that because it's classified? He's a freaking president, okay? The president has the power to classify or declassify things essentially just by talking about it, you know? There's no power. In the American government that's going to tell the president, the sitting president, otherwise. And one can raise the argument that, he's not the president anymore, so he can't hold on to these declassified documents. Well, if they're declassified, yes, he can. They don't instantly become classified again once he leaves the Oval Office. That's not how the big government works, you know what I'm saying? Got our skill tree here. What am I, level 10 now? I think I'm level 10 now, so leather armor. Oh, no wonder it's taking up so much room. Alright, hold on. Drop this. Pick that up. Alright. Now I have four buddies. Check me out. Alright, this is definitely better. I need a hard leather hat now. But yeah, essentially that this whole Trump raid thing, it's all bullshit. Bullshit made up, designed to distract you from what I believe is the biggest news that they're trying to hide now from you, is that the January 6th committee is essentially all overdone with. There will be no prosecution of Trump. Basically, the only thing they may have at this point, as far as getting Trump is concerned, is the civil case they have against him. The civil lawsuit, whatever you want to call it. They might have him there. But, I mean, what is a civil lawsuit? That's just money. You might have to pay some money. But Trump's made of money. It's got money flowing through his veins, okay? I'm sure he shits money, okay? I can just imagine Trump sitting on the top, squeezing out $100 bills left and right. Squeezing out that money right out of his cheeks, man. That's Trump right there. So, I mean, a civil suit isn't really going to hurt him. It might inconvenience him. That's really the most you're gonna get out of him. It's just minor inconvenience. It's a minor embarrassment. I mean, all they really have to go on right now in the news is the fact that he pled the Fifth Amendment like 11 times or something like that. Or no, 494 times he pled the Fifth Amendment. He wasn't going to talk because I guess somehow it might affect his the federal case against him, the whatever's going on. I can't even keep track of so many lawsuits going on right now. Whatever criminal case they dreamed up against him, His lawyers, Trump's lawyers, advised him not to say anything on the stand, and on the grounds that it might incriminate his the criminal cases going on against him. They didn't want one thing to contradict the other, which is wise. But now his haters are saying that. Because he said a while back that only guilty people or only criminals plead the Fifth Amendment or something like that. Trump apparently said this a while back. That makes him a hypocrite somehow. I don't know. And they're comparing him to Hillary Clinton, who never pled the Fifth at all. That's right, she never pled the Fifth at all. But she only said, "I don't recall," over and over again for about 11 hours straight when they had her being questioned about her 33,000 destroyed emails or deleted emails. You're telling me that saying "I don't recall" is not the same as pleading the Fifth Amendment? I mean, that's essentially what she did. And as I told somebody, Trump essentially just tore a page from their book of Words Matter, you know. Because remember what Bill Clinton said? Words matter. They certainly do. Especially when you're on the stand getting questioned by prosecutors. I as you can see here, there's a lot of downtime in between the action. Why I had the freedom to talk as much as I am right now. It's a bit more laid back and relaxing than Diablo 3 was. That latest, not-so-greatest Diablo game that's out, I'm in no hurry to pick that one up at all. Doesn't look that appealing to me. Even though I guess it's like, isn't it like free to play or something? Free to play? I mean, yeah, there's free to play where you don't have to pay money up front. But there's also the issue of, well, it still takes up space on my hard drive, so. So it's not really free. My hard drives are so filled up now that, what do you call it? Space is limited. This guy. Yeah, recently, or was it last night, I bit the bullet and I renewed my subscription to it's a Game Pass Ultimate. Because I have some games on gold that I haven't really played yet. They're on my hard drive now and I don't know. Let's figure what the heck, why not? Gonna hurt. There is that new game coming out, I think it's next month, that Plague Tale Requiem or something like that. That one looks pretty good. I really need to do a stream of the first game, which I do own. I actually bought that one. Looks great on optimized XS Series X. Graphics are just fantastic. Some may argue it's just a tech demo, but you know, some tech demos can be really fun to play, like Rise Son of Rome is a great example. I streamed that just what, last week? That one was really fun. To actually sit there and actually sit down and actually concentrate on playing the game. The game got way better as it went on. I do want to continue that one at some point here. I'm just romping right through this game with these my poor little sidekicks here. I've already been to this area. Here. Not carrying them. Why the hell not? Hold on. Make some room here. Can't use this yet. can't. I shan't. A ton of these scrolls. Here's what we'll do. Go to my stash. Save some of this crap. See, I don't use enough of these mana potions for in the game yet to really need to keep carrying them around everywhere, so I am going to stash some of my shit here. Don't need to be carrying all this crap around. Felicitous Ring. 10% chance, better chance of getting magical items. There we go. There we go. Alright. Camel's Highland. Few monsters in this area. Oh, who are these guys? Other unrelated news, I guess, what's her face? That actress, Anne Heche, was declared brain dead yesterday. Which, according to California law, if you're brain dead, that means you're dead. No chance of revival. I felt bad for her, but. To a point, I mean, she did, essentially put countless lives at risk by doing what she did. Not saying she deserved to die, because nobody deserves to die, but Well, you know, people would be singing a much different tune if she had actually hurt those people that she crashed, hurt those people at the house that she crashed into with her car. I mean, I'm just saying, thank God she didn't kill anybody, but before taking herself out, you know. I wish they'd do a remake of the first Diablo game. Remember, I bought it for the PS1, and I have it on my PC too. But there was a I don't know what it was. It's like a mod or something they did for the first Diablo game. It's called, I think, Hellbound or something like that. I got it on my PC. On my computer, and that one's pretty fun. I really wish they'd do a remake of that game though, because even though this game is superior to that one, or Diablo 2 is superior to Diablo 1, Diablo 1 was still fun to play, you know. Thank you. There we go. That looks a little better. I look pretty badass now, aren't I? Level 1. Alright. A dungeon. I like the dungeon levels in this game. They look all, you know, they look, dungeon-y. Talk about what they're doing at Trump a lot, right? Sometimes they may be asking, well, are there any Democrats that I do like? Not really. And that Tulsi Gabbard for a little while there looked promising for what she did to Kamala Harris at the debates. A couple years ago, right? Until I looked at Tulsi Gabbard's call it. Kind of looked at her politics. Tulsi Gabbard's a gun grabber. She wants to take away your guns and all that stuff. She's all for gun control. You know, anybody who only wants to take away, you know, that's not a good hill to defend, let's put it that way. Any policy that is designed or meant to take away rights or to limit rights from the American people is never a good policy. Never. Thank you. let's be realistic here. They might, you know, make it look all cool that, you know, gun control, but the only people that have ever done mass shootings are crazy people. And as I've said before, I have no time for crazy. If you're crazy, just get the hell away from me and my family, right? I have no time for you or your problems. That's about as compassionate as I'm gonna get regarding those people, okay? Criminally insane belong in hospitals, in mental asylums. If your argument is, well, there are none, they're all closed. Well, it's not true, they're not all closed. Still open and available, but, Instead of gun control policies, they should be coming up with crazy control policies. Take the crazies off the streets. They're letting them wander around freely, potentially being dangers to society. Go after those people. Leave the guns alone. A gun all by itself will not kill anybody. A gun by itself is harmless. What is, as I was saying, a gun by itself is harmless. A gun in the hands of a crazy person, however, criminally insane, that's another story entirely. They're looking at this entire issue ass backwards. Don't control the guns, control the people, the crazy people that want the guns. They put even a fraction of as much energy in controlling the amount of crazies on the streets as they did trying to get the guns out of the hands of law-abiding citizens. Crime rate would go way, way, way down in a very short amount of time. Cannot deny that. Oh, there you are. They keep getting resurrected here. What's going on? Where is it? it's back here. Hit level 2, yeah! MAGA! I just love saying that word. It's a word now. All this way for nothing? Well, by the look of it, unexplored section over here. But check it out. There we go. There's my stash. No. It's strength 40 to do that. Over here for now. you find that A point. Is that it right there? Oh shoot. Right here. No, that's not it. Go. Get over there. Need to find the waypoint so we can start our game from there, or any future games from there. It's got to be around here somewhere. Stamina. Oops. Trapped. Thank you. right here? No, it's not it. Every little region you go to, it has a waypoint somewhere, and we need to find the waypoint for this area. That way, next time I save my game, I could go back to right to this area instead of having to walk all the way over here. Remember, my stash. Gotta make room, you know? I can do this one now. Alright, look at me go. Carry this now. Let's go find all my other stuff. I've forgotten where. Oh, it's up there. I got killed up here somewhere, so I gotta go find him. Need to find that waypoint too. I think first of all I need to find my guy got killed. I believe it's right over here somewhere. Thank you. There it is. Skullcap, it's gone. Somehow my skull can't went missing. Doing that. I gotta find that save point. Over here. Thank you. rubber band. I need a cat, so drop this. Grab that. A cap. That'll do for now. How do I get in there? Won't let me in. I'm trying to find a save point so I can save my game and probably call it a night. I'm getting kind of sleepy. And you know the cliche, I do have to work tomorrow morning. About 3:35 a.m. here in Alaska right now. Pretty much every part of this area map here. We check up here, I guess. Highland. Oh, I don't see it. Thank you. Those are doorways, okay. Ah, here we go. Dash again. Let's go visit this guy. All right. Go. Yeah, I think I'm gonna use this as a good like a stopping point. Been about over a couple hours now. Get a little sleepy. I do have a appointment in a little over 6 hours. I probably get some shut out here. Yeah, hey, anybody who was watching tonight, thanks for watching. Good time to spend a Friday night playing an old classic like this. But yeah, if you watch this far, I do appreciate the audience as always. Anybody who has to work today like me, hope you have a good work day. Hope it's not raining where you are like it's raining up here. It's raining pretty solid for almost a month now. But yeah, we're gonna call it quits for tonight. I'm going to save and exit. And, well, yeah. I will, see you folks on the flip side. Till then, I am out of here. Peace.